now on News Center 5.
Could he get out of jail? Former Patriot star Aaron Hernandez in court this afternoon seeking bail in his murder case.
Concerns about a rare brain disease spread to Massachusetts. The connection to a Cape Cod hospital. 5 patients there. And a fall chill in the air, but a warmer weekend is ahead. Find out when we could see some showers.
From Boston's news leader, this is WCVB News Center 5 Midday.
Good afternoon, everyone. We're actually breaking, following a lot of news, breaking news in Everett, Sky 5, over a neighborhood where there is a heavy police presence today. Many officers with guns drawn. Witnesses tell us that they heard several shots fired earlier this morning.
Here's what we know right now. 4 nearby schools are in lockdown. We want to go out to News Center 5's Jorge Quiroga, who's live at the scene with the very latest. Jorge?
Well, it's a pretty tense situation here. Although the police are heavily armed, the SWAT team is here, they're certainly not making any move. They're planning their moves at this point. Now, we are told that neighbors are telling us, and that's confirmed also by the folks at the Patty Care Daycare Center here at the intersection of Calhoun Ave and Elm Street, that at some point a little while ago they heard 4 gunshots. All the children in that daycare center have been locked inside. 4 schools in the area are also on lockdown mode: Everett High School, the Kavarian School, the Lafayette School, and Webster School. In the meantime, everybody is standing around. The focus of all this police activity seems to be a house with an orange balcony in the middle of Calhoun Ave. Again, no information, no details have been given as to what's going on and what exactly happened. But police did tell me that nobody has been hurt. But obviously, this is a tense situation. Somebody inside that house has done something. Obviously, they imagine that that's the person who may have fired off at least 4 shots. That's what the people heard. Somebody else told me they heard 5 shots. But anyway, that is where the attention of this intense police presence is focused. A house in the middle of the street, everybody looking at the 3rd floor of that house. Police are not giving out any other information, but obviously it's a tense situation. It's a standoff. Nobody making any sudden moves, but the whole area is cordoned off.
Jorge Quiroga reporting live from the scene for us.